I'm sure you've seen this picture of Lieutenant General AAK Niazi signing the instrument of surrender after the 1971 war. But do you know who is the Indian gentleman sitting with him? He is Lieutenant General Jagjit Singh Aurora, and today we are going to talk about him on today's episode of House of Defense. Jagjit Singh Aurora was born on 13 February 1916 in Kala Gujran of Jhelum district in Punjab. He was the son of an engineer. Aurora graduated from the Indian Military Academy in 1939 and was commissioned into the 1st Battalion, 2nd Punjab Regiment. He saw action in the Burma campaign during World War II. After independence and the ensuing partition of India, he opted to join the Indian Army and was a commissioned officer in the Punjab Regiment during the Indo-Pakistani War of 1947. As a brigadier, he fought in the Sino-Indian War in 1962. He also participated in the Indo-Pakistani War of 1965. On 8 June 1969, he was appointed the General Officer Commanding in Chief of the Indian Army's Eastern Command. In March 1971, the Pakistan Army launched Operation Searchlight to curb the Bengali nationalist movement in East Pakistan. The operation resulted in the 1971 Bangladesh atrocities, including the systematic murder of Bengalis by the Pakistan Army. The ensuing violence led to almost 10 million Bengali refugees fleeing from East Pakistan into India. For the next 8 months, with tensions escalating between India and Pakistan and anticipating possible hostilities, Aurora oversaw the logistical preparations of the Indian Army on the Eastern Front, including the improvement of roads, communications and bridges, as well as the movement of 30,000 tons of supplies close to the border with East Pakistan. At the outbreak of the war on 3rd December 1971, as Eastern Army Commander, General Aurora led the Indian ground forces into battle in East Pakistan. In a meticulously planned operation, forces under Aurora's command formed numerous small combat teams and launched a forefront attack with the strategy of confronting and defeating the Pakistani forces on selected fronts while bypassing Pakistani forces on others. In under 2 weeks, his forces advanced from the Indian border to capture Dhaka, the capital of East Pakistan. The unified commander of Pakistan Armed Forces Eastern Military High Command, Lieutenant General Amir Abdullah Khan Niazi, was forced to sign an unconditional instrument of surrender. The photograph of Niazi and Aurora at the signing of the instrument of surrender became an iconic image of the war. The 90,000 Pakistani troops under Niazi's command surrendered to General Aurora as prisoners of war. Pakistan lost almost 57,000 square miles of its territory and 70 million of its people to the newly formed nation of Bangladesh. Aurora was honored with the Param Vishisht Seva Medal and the Padma Bhushan for his role in the war. He retired from the Indian Army in 1973. But he was an active member of the Citizens Justice Committee, which provided pro bono assistance to Sikh victims of the 1984 anti-Sikh riots. Jagjit Singh Aurora died on 3rd May 2005 at the age of 89 in New Delhi. He was survived by a son and a daughter. After his death, the gratitude of Bangladesh to General Aurora was emphasized in a message to India from Murshed Khan, the Bangladeshi foreign minister, stating, "Aurora will be remembered in the history of Bangladesh for his contribution during our war of liberation in 1971 when he led the Allied forces." I hope you like this video about Lieutenant General Jagjit Singh Aurora, and if you did, please share it with your friends, your family, subscribe to My Nation, and keep watching House of Defense.